Morning, Marcus. What are you up to?
So now we've completed all of our dead test gas, we're actually going to start looking at live testing. And we're going to look at the importance of the first live test, which is often overlooked, which is obviously recheck polarity of supply.
Okay, so the example being, so I've dead all my dead tests.
Yep.
This is not doing a live test. I'm plugging something in. It works.
Yeah,
we're
out
of here. So that's not acceptable.
No, this is for the video purposes.
Okay. Only. Yeah, we like that. So if I turn my one back off and your plug-in voltage indicator, which wouldn't be the test we're carrying out, we're going to look at that in a minute. What is that telling me at this stage anyhow?
So from the indicating lamps on the tester, it's actually showing us that we have a line neutral reverse, so incorrect polarity between line and neutral.
And that can't be the case if we've done, and we have, all our dead
all
tests
our dead
correctly.
Tests. And we've confirmed the dead test polarity as
we
well.
We have, so we've done our bit correctly.
Yep.
So of course, it must be further back in the system where we've got an issue, not necessarily at this socket. So we won't be taking this socket off and confirming the connections in the back of it, which we might do on an electrical installation condition report.
Yep.
We're actually going to go into the consumer unit and do what test again?
So we're going to recheck polarity of supply of our approved voltage indicator.
Okay, let's do that next. So Marcus, if we're performing the test in the correct sequence, this isn't quite what we would be doing, obviously, on an initial verification.
No.
This might be more of a periodic thing. You've locked off the main switch.
Yep.
What's your thinking behind that for this video?
So the reason I've locked off the main switch, Gaz, is because obviously we've got now got concerns of our incoming supply polarity, so it might be an issue with the DNO side.
Yeah.
So if I was to accidentally energize this main switch here, then the neutral bars would actually be the line conductor, so there's a much greater risk of electric shock.
Okay, I like your thinking behind that. And if this was part of a periodic inspection where an installation condition report was being installed, I'd be looking now at the colours of conductors in colours and places.
Yeah, of course you would.
So as we look here, are we happy that all the brown conductors are out going on the lines through the breakers? CBCs and neutrals are in the appropriate places.
Yeah, correct.
So we're not thinking it's an incorrectly wired circuit.
No.
And we're looking at this from a point of view that our learners have carried out all their dead tests correctly before moving on to a live test.
Our live test.
Remind me of that first live test again.
Recheck polarity of supply.
Right, so we're concerned about the incoming supply, which could be reversed. Where could it be reversed?
So it could be reversed at the meter. So if you've maybe had a new smart meter installed, okay, but we have actually checked that and it isn't the case. So now we're looking further down the line, which is the DNO side that we're concerned about.
Again, we've got a Lynx main or double pole switch here.
Yep.
Again, we've confirmed that the connections in there are correct.
Correct.
We believe the connections here are correct through tracing them through. So we're actually thinking it could be possibly in the road.
Yeah, maybe they've done a joint and done an incorrect joint somewhere.
However, if it is a reverse polarity and it was at the meter, is that something we could change ourselves? Could we
We would still need to ring the energy supplier or the owner of the meter itself, maybe Eon British Gas, someone like that.
Okay, so let's get prepared for the next test, which is, just to remind me again,
rechecking polarity of supply.
Which is really important. So all the awarding bodies and endpoint assessments require us to check our voltage indicator for using it. Is that the case even though we're doing this supply polarity check?
Yeah, so just like the safe isolation steps, Gaz, we're going to have to prove our approved voltage indicator first. Now, we could do this on a known source or a proven unit. However, I'm going to do this on a proven unit today.
Okay, so, so all good?
Yeah.
So onto the test itself now.
Yeah.
Okay, we've jiggled the camera around. We're going to try and keep out of view. And I've got one end of the voltage indicator.
And I have the other one.
Okay, so you tell me what we want to do, Marcus, first.
So the first step we're going to do, we're going to go between line and earth. So I want you to probe onto the least dangerous conductor first, being the earthing conductor.
So the earth bar here, I'm onto that.
And then I'm going to probe onto the line. Now, this is where we should expect to see voltage. However, where our concerns were earlier, we're not seeing voltage here. So my concern is line and neutral reverse.
Okay. And that was what we were indicated on the plug-in voltage indicator as well. So I'll take off mine now.
Yeah.
So some precautions now moving forward, because we'd expect now possibly it to be live this time. So if we go back onto the earth bar where the CPCs are connected.
So least dangerous first, then the most dangerous.
Ah,
now we've got our voltage has appeared now.
Okay, so you'll need to come off yours first and then mine. So we'll still prove the third one. We will go in here, but going to be some cautions now, isn't it?
Yeah, because normally we'd go on the least dangerous being the neutral. However, now we've got our suspicions the neutral is actually the line conductor.
Okay.
We're going to have to probe onto the line conductor first and then the neutral.
Do you want to do that for me? So you're going to go on the line conductor first. This is odd. And then onto the neutral. And hopefully, we can see that, that's illuminated. So you're going to come off the...
The neutral being the most dangerous. It's a bit of an awkward one when you're not used
to it. So we've got a reverse polarity. So we've got the line and neutral that are correctly colour-coded here.
Yep.
They're actually physically the wrong way round. It's back here. So we understand by looking that the connections are correct here and correct in the meter inside. So we believe the issue is down here, actually in the road maybe, Marcus?
Yeah, potentially, yes.
So all it leaves us now to do, Marcus, is pull the camera back, recheck our voltage indicator on a known source or a proven unit in our case, and then just summarise where we got to.
So now that I've gone through them stages, all that's left for me to do is now reprove my voltage indicator. I'm going to do that back on my proven unit, and as you can see, everything is still fine.
So think of this as the scenario, is you've done all your dead tests, they're all correct.
Yep,
you've done your continuity CPCs and your polarities. You've energised your installation, first test being?
The recheck and supply polarity.
Okay, good. And we've gone and now checked that, and actually we've got a reverse polarity of line, a neutral in this installation. Yeah. Right, okay. If we hadn't done that, we'd livened up all the circuits, Marcus. Yep. Nothing would work, would it?
Yeah, everything would work as normal.
No. Yes, gosh, shock would, horror. Yeah. So what would be now a risk?
So we've got certain risks such as Edison screw lamp holders.
Yeah.
The outer contact, instead of being connected to the neutral now, will be connected to the line conductor. Mm. Our polarity of our socket outlets, they will also be incorrect.
Yes.
And also a big one for me, Gaz, is all single pole devices will not no longer be switching the line conductor. However, they'll be switching the neutral. So in the event of, let's say, an exposed conductive part becoming live, ADS will not disconnect the circuit breaker in the correct time.
So what we're saying there is that with a reverse supply polarity, the fuse is in effectively now the neutral conductor and not in the line conductor. The outer metal work becomes live.
Yep.
We're expected to disconnect under ADS, but we've actually got the fuse, no fuse in the neutral.
No.
So we've got a chance that the circuit isn't going to disconnect.
No.
Leading to a risk of three things. Yep. Those three things are...
shock, fire and explosion.
That's one for our learners. Yep. Okay. So obviously, yeah, we can see how crucial it is then that the first test is put in place correctly.
Yeah.
Because obviously when we start doing a fault loop impedance test, having not done supply polarity, we'd be probing in and thinking, oh, this doesn't work.
Yeah.
It doesn't work. What's going on? And you start unpicking circuits when actually it's the supply polarity.
Yeah. And just the simpleness of that first live test.
Yeah.
Ensures you that you have the correct supply plan.
And you'll be expected to do that under your sitting guild and EAL internal assessments as well as your external AM2 or AM2S as well. So me and Marcus hope this has helped you both in testing and fault finding, and we'll follow it up with
we hope this video has been some help.